they're making.
Yeah, but I think he's in billiards. He just, I don't think he was just a good angle player. You know, like I think he was just intending to angle that better.
It was draw weight and curling is not really fine tuned.
On the faceoff, Sobotka goes down, but Stajan wins it. Now the pass back is picked off, and we get a whistle from the linesman in the corner. And Sobotka is heading off.
Concealing the puck on the ice off the faceoff, I believe, is going to be the call. You can't put your hand down there. Sobotka getting down low on the draws, as he always does. Strong legs, strong lower body, an incredibly tough athlete, and good hand-eye coordination, but we'll keep our eye on the faceoff. There goes down. Let's see if he puts his hand. Well, the linesman makes the call. You can see the linesman there on your left, and he makes the call.
That puck came under his body, and we did not see from that angle if he concealed it, but that was the call made by the linesman. And the Flames on the power play, they're 0 for 5 with 5 shots and down by a goal.
The Blues had the first 3 power plays. The Flames have had the last 6, including this one.
And they drop it off for Hudler. Right up the middle. Now to Wyman, a shot, and that was high and wide. And then Russell back on the line. That goes to the corner. Petrangelo there. Colburn knocked it away. Now Camilleri throws one far side to Hudler. Hudler back on the line to Wyman. And a shot. That was blocked by Steen. And a diving play by Backes to get it out. And we will watch Redabera in the net. They could pull him and make it a 6-on-4.
I didn't like the sound of that puck hitting Steen's ankle either.
No,
it made a thud. It didn't make a nice kind of sound.
Nope.
Now Hudler gets the puck to the corner, turning his Barrett Jackman, and right up the gap and all the way down the ice.
The two key players here tonight. Oshie takes that slap shot in the foot in the second period, and now Steen here late.
Here are the Flames back in. 1:40 left in the third, 45 to go in the power play. And again, the Blues cleared away.
Now we'll keep our eye. I think Bob Hartman's going to call the goaltender, but this is going to be icing right now.
And
yes, it is.
That's a break for the Blues, and the goaltender, Barra, will obviously have to come back in with 1:29 to go in the third period.
Oh, it was the right time to take the goalie out, but the player on the ice had a little bit of the happy hands trying to move it forward.
And Steen is back on the ice. Coming up next, Missouri Lottery Blues Live. 38 seconds left in Sobotka's minor.
The award-winning Pat Parris at the helm.
Multi-awards for Pat Parris, for good reason. Blues have blocked 18 shots tonight, including those two by Oshie and Steen. Flames control the faceoff. Here comes Brody. And now picked up by Hudler. There goes Bear off the ice for a 6th attacker. Elliott for the empty net. And that is blocked by Brody.
Mike Smith scored one earlier
yes,
this year.
Yes, he did. 15 to go in the power play. Steen at center ice. Russell gets it back for the Flames. Now into Jones. That pass blocked. Goes back to the goal. Final minute now. Petrangelo off the boards and down the ice. That goes wide. Sobotka is back. The Flames had one shot, 50 seconds left. Blues up by one. Russell to center ice. And that is tipped in. Here's Hudler, shoots it around. Camilleri to the front. Jones was there. Comes back in the goal crease area, and it's covered by Brian Elliott.
And you get some protection, too. You've got to smother the crease area. Make sure you push all the white sweaters the heck out of the way in that situation. Don't look for the puck. Let the goalie take care of the puck. And you see Hudler, that one just flops over his twig right there. And now you box out. As soon as this happens, you box out. Great position by Petrangelo there. See, Bollmeister's just a little bit caught on the outside, but shoving and pushing. Make sure everybody's aware of where that puck is and where the open man might be. But you've got to take the sticks out of the way.
Good play there by Elliott to get that puck under that mitt there, because that puck is bouncing right there, and if it bounced over his glove, it's in big trouble.
Well, Blues fans, a quick reminder that next Tuesday is a big game against Phoenix, and it's the next Ticketmaster Tuesday night. Get 2 tickets and 2 t-shirts for only $63. Visit stlouisblues.com/hotdeals for details.
T-shirt Tuesdays. I like
Phoenix is off to a great start.
Are they ever? They are.
So the timeout by Bob Hartley. With 36.2 left, Sabolkin will take it for the Blues. And Camilleri, I believe, or Jones will step in. It will be Jones, who's a winger, but the right-handed shot and a big man.
Yep, big, strong kid. He'll try to take this off the boards to Russell at the right point.
The net is empty for the Flames, down by one. As Sabolkin gets set. And it goes to the corner, grabbed by Camilleri. Puck up in the air, and then gloved down by Wyman on the near side. Now played back of the goal, swatted around by Bollmeister. Camilleri passed right to the slot, and that went by everybody. Blues can't get to it. Goes back of the goal again, Colbert. Now back in line to Russell. He'll tip one back of the goal, fired around by Petrangelo. And at the line, Wyman, good job to hold it in. Now Sabolka follows up, and he gets the puck to center. And 5 seconds left. And here's Russell. Long feed to Hutler. At the buzzer, and a save by Elliott. And the Blues win it. They hang on and win 3-2.
Well, even though Elliott's streak of 110 minutes and 46 seconds of shutout hockey was snapped in this game, he was terrific in goal. The Blues had the great start they were looking for. They led 3-0, but boy, oh boy, Calgary didn't go away in this game and tested Elliott and the Blues defense for the last half of the game.
Third period goals by Jackman and Camilleri made it very interesting, but the Blues killed off a late power play and they win it 3-2 to go to 10-2-2 on the year, and they kick off the homestand with a big win. Salute the crowd of Scott Trey.
Well, as the players exit the ice, our Bud Light player of the game is going to be your NHL goal-scoring leader. His 14th goal of the season, and it ends up being the game-winning goal, the third of the game. Played almost 20 minutes, had the one goal, six shots on goal, a couple of block shots, including the one in the third where he took it right on the laces on a wicked one-timer. Another solid game for Alexander Steen.
His third game winner of the year. Let's go to Tom Calhoun.
Stars of tonight's game. The game's third star with one assist and playing on defense for the Calgary Flames, number 44, Chris Butler. The game's second star, recording two assists and playing on defense for the Blues, number 33, Jordan Leopold. And the game's first star, with one goal, his 14th of the season. Playing in a forward for the Blues, number 20, Alexander Steen. Enjoy tonight's victory a little longer with the on-the-run.
Sorry for the technical issues. We'll get down to Bernie Federko hopefully shortly to hear from Alexander Steen, the first star of tonight's hockey game, as the Blues hold on to win by the final of 3-2. They took that 3-0 lead on Alex Steen's goal just over 5 minutes into the second period. But then it was the Calgary Flames taking advantage of many power play opportunities and eventually coming back to cut it to one goal. We'll continue here with Blues hockey after the 3-2 victory.